Hey y'all, it is my birthday, so we about to make some noise. Hey, come on in. I'm about to invite some people. We're just starting a little bit early, so come on through. I'm just inviting everybody, to be honest with you. So just come on in. I'm starting a little bit early because I want to like just get through some get through some things before we bring our special guest on. So we are starting a little bit early. Come on in, share the video, invite people on that need to stay encouraged and just want to turn up because it is my birthday. And it's the birthday turn up tonight. So I'm excited. So come on in. I cannot see the comments yet because I'm inviting people in. So let's just get down to it. So I'm excited. I'm so excited for tonight. Like I said, we're starting a little bit early because I don't want to go past 8:25 because I have some other things to do today. So with that being said, I just wanted to get us started. So like, share, bring some people on here. I'm just inviting some people I said that would come on. So yeah, just come on in. I'm excited. So how is everybody? I will see the comments here in a second, but right now I can't see them. So yeah, invite some people on, come on through. I am so ready to go to encourage you guys for real. So come on in. Thank you. Hey, girl. Hey, sis. Thank you. Yeah, it's my birthday, so I'm going to make some noise, y'all. 29. Okay. It's a Baltimore Club mix. It's like one of my, Janessa's grand plays it for me every year. So since she's not here, yeah. So can y'all see me? Vincy says she doesn't see or hear anything. And I am not on Wi-Fi, so it's not me. Hey, Joshua. Hey, Sorrell. Can everybody hear and see me? Well, yeah, obviously you can hear me because you said, what song am I playing? So, I was turning up, y'all. It is my birthday, 29, okay? I am excited. So, I want to get started before we bring on Pastor Evan. He's coming in like 10 minutes, I think. And he's probably like, what is she doing starting early? Because I did not tell him. So anyway, we're just going to get down to it. And I really just wanted to come on before he came on and just to really say thank you for all the, I'm still inviting people on if you guys can't hear me. Just to say thank you to every single person that has reached out today and that has said happy birthday and just that, you know, everybody that has really just reached out today because today's special. So it's not just my birthday, but it's also the birth of Wednesday Encourage started. So I am so excited. And I just want to just share some things with you. I just wanted to say thank you to every single person. Like, you guys encourage me all the time. And especially today, y'all showed out. So I, as you have seen, I have been in Chicago. That's feeling like my second home right now. So I've been in Chicago. Chicago owes me absolutely nothing. This weekend was amazing. And I'm excited to just pour out to you guys tonight and just to encourage you guys. And everyone's like, why are you doing it live on your birthday? But I honestly know that one of my purposes in life and just why I am birthed, thank you, was to keep you guys encouraged and was to keep the people encouraged. And I love it. I absolutely love it. And so I just want to give you guys a backdrop of tonight. I think the topic is remaining encouraged. And the story for that is, so everybody saw the picture from Chicago. I did a fashion shoot with Martin Lawrence brand. Yeah, Martin Lawrence. I keep calling him Martin Lawrence. Micah Lawrence. He's going to kill me. Micah Lawrence brand. And we did a photo shoot. And that whole day was just from Satan. Like, and it wasn't even from Satan because it really was just God and just a divine setup. But to me in it, it was from Satan. I kept calling my friend like, I am not, yes, Micah Lawrence, Martin Lawrence. So I was so mad, y'all. And so what happened was, I didn't know Chicago shut down the day before St. Patrick's Day, shut all the roads down. My Lyft driver didn't, I mean, I've only been in Chicago a couple times, but I don't know the routes. So I had no idea what she was doing, no idea how to get there and I had a makeup appointment. And usually, like right now, I don't have makeup on, so I don't need makeup. But it was a fashion show. Like it was a shoot. It was a headshot shoot. It was my birthday shoot. I was excited. And I was like, okay, I have everything planned out. My flight's going to leave at this time. Shoot's going to be at this time. Makeup is at this time. So I missed my first flight. I was mad. Had to go a whole hour to a different airport to catch a flight because I'm like, I can't delay this any longer. And so I was just, anybody that knows me knows I like to plan things. I'm a planned person. I love being spontaneous, but I don't like when I have plans that they don't go as planned. Like that really irks me. So I was so upset and I almost went home. I'm almost like, you know what? I'm not doing this. But then I forgot, like my friends had blessed me. So they made my way to Chicago. That was great. So I said, okay, I'm going to let them down. If I don't get there, let me get there. Get to Chicago, traffic. My Lyft driver, what took a half an hour drive, I was in the car for an hour, folks, like dying. And I actually got out. I said, just leave me out somewhere. I got to get out of this car because I was motion sickness. I was upset because I missed my makeup appointment and I was over it. And I didn't listen to my first mind say, take your makeup bag. So I only had pink lip gloss. That's all I had. I was like, okay, whatever. I said, thank God I'm pretty. So I did get a little vain and conceited. You know, my brother Rodney had to kick me down a few steps, but I was like, you know what? Thank God for clear skin. It's going to work. I'm going to wear sunglasses. We're going to call it a day. So I get there and I was so mad. And I was like, you know what, guys? I don't even want to do it anymore. Appreciate your time. We're good. Keep the money. I don't want to do it anymore because I don't have makeup on and these are headshot. These are birthday pictures. I'm so mad at this point. Micah looks at me. He said, girl, you are not canceling. Hey, Kaz. Hey, guys. So he was like, you're not canceling. You need to keep going. Just do it. I was like, fine. I'll put some, you know, the pink lip gloss that y'all saw in a picture on. Call it a day. I was not pleased. But in that moment, it worked. So when Micah sent me the picture, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. When Micah sent me the picture of like the unedited one, I was like, oh my gosh, you could have never told me that all these things happened to get that shot. So that is my encouragement to you guys of how we're going to remain single. Yes, single. Remain encouraged. I hope y'all are not remaining single. How we're going to remain, that's my next point. We're going to remain encouraged is that it may not look like it's going to be a masterpiece. Because listen, sweethearts and brothers, I did not think that picture was going to come out good. Like, I was like, it ain't it. And ask Micah, ask Rodney, everybody was there, knew, like, Corey is done. She's over it. I said, Micah, just take two pictures. I get one to share on my birthday. I don't care. So what I want to encourage somebody is how you remain encouraged is I could have left. I could have been like, you know what? I'm done. I don't want to do this anymore. It's not going the way I had seen it. It's not going the way I pictured it. I'm ugly. I don't look like it pictured in my head because in my head, my face was beat and I had blue, you know, stuff on and whatever. I didn't want to wear sunglasses in this picture. But that particular moment, God was like, that's not how I run things. That's not, your thoughts are not my thoughts. So he might have wanted me to have sunglasses because my future is so bright and he wanted the skyline view. Thank you guys so much. I really was discouraged. I really called everybody and their mother to tell them, like, I am done. Yes, it was a message. So I want to encourage somebody that's like, listen, I don't know where this masterpiece is coming from. Because listen, I cried. When Micah sent me that picture, I was tearful. Now everybody knows I'm a crybaby. But I mean, I cried because I would have never thought. I was like, you know, it's going to be about like maybe a 5 or a 6. It's not my best day. It was amazing. And it blew my mind. It wasn't even what I thought because I had in my mind, like, I look a stank fool with some pink lip. I don't have no face on, just like this, with some glasses and lip gloss. And then I was like, you know what? The simplest things, God turns into the most beautiful things. And I realized in that moment, the glow doesn't come from a face of makeup. The glow doesn't come from, and I know that sounds so cliche because I really don't wear makeup a lot, but this glow isn't from outside sources. This glow is really from obedience and just doing what God has intended us to do. So I just want to encourage somebody who's like, how can I remain encouraged? What does that look like? And I want to tell you guys, and see, Rodney came on so he could tell you I was a plum fool at the photo shoot. So, you know, anyway. So I want to encourage you guys that it may not look right now what it's supposed to look like. And I want to actually be, you know, we're always real and honest and stuff like that. And same with this birthday. I turned 29, 29 and fine, y'all, and divine. And I know you, this year's going to be divine. But how many of you have timelines? And I don't know about you, but I had a timeline. I was actually going to be married this year and pregnant next year. That was my timeline. Had a boyfriend, you know, y'all have publicly seen who my ex was, and you know, I have permission to share the story, but I was planning to marry him. He was actually going to propose, like, for my birthday. This week was the proposal, and we've talked about it, and so I was like, yes, like, we're gonna get married, I'm having a child, I'm gonna be pregnant, and you know, I'm popping it out, so for the 30th, I'm gonna be out in Mexico. Like, I just had this all thing planned in my head. Like a month ago, God tell, like, hey, we ain't it for each other. We're friends. I was like, no, that ain't it. And I really wanted to be selfish because I was like, no, it's okay. Cause we good. We best friend. We gonna make it work. And we both had to really seek God for a while. It wasn't just like a quick spontaneous decision. We had to really seek God for a while to get our answer. Like, hey, this isn't no marriage, no engagement. And I was devastated. I was discouraged, guys. I was discouraged because it's like at 29 years old, you think you know what's good for you. You think you know how your life is going to go. And I just had a picture. It was like picture perfect. Yes, you need Rodney's story with all the dramatics and hand motions. So when it doesn't go that way, you're like, what is going on? Like, did I do something? Did I not hear correctly? Am I being punished? Because at first it's like everything was going great. So I'm like, what is going on? You know, am I just not ready to be a wife? What is it? And half of it is I was not ready. But a lot of it was, that's just not God's masterpiece sometimes for us. And that's okay. So when you get discouraged, because I was like discouraged for like a week or two. And I still am. Like, you just, you know, it was a good relationship. Jarrell's a good guy. And he's on here so I can say that. He's a great man. And so when you lose great men and women in your life and you're like, oh, this surely is a punishment, I want to tell somebody, you're not being punished. You're just being positioned to the posture of obedience that's for your life. And that was so good. I love these like new revelation things. But, you know, we're not discouraged. It hurt. We cried. We shed some tears. I obviously took my Pinterest board down for my wedding ideas because that was with him. So the new, you know, whoever God wants to send to find me, I got to redo that. So I don't like to do the whole redo. So I want to encourage you exactly, it's not a punishment, it's positioning. So I want to encourage those of you that are discouraged right now because you really feel like, hey, I had this timeline. It's nothing like I wanted it. I mean, literally, this year is nothing the way I planned it. Because again, I would have been sharing like, I say yes, you know, and now I'm sharing, hey, I'm about to take over the world and run some cities. And that's fine because I know that that's the will of God. So stay encouraged knowing it is not a punishment. It's just a position. It's a reposition. It's an adjustment to the will of God for your life. And I don't know about you, but the best place to be, and we always say that, and sometimes it's cliche, but the best place to be is in the will of God. And the best place to be is just having peace about it. And things begin to flow better. And you open up the areas of your life that God really has to come in and work in. Thank you, boo. And you really just present yourself to God as a sacrifice, really, to say, you know, hey, I'm available. It's not about me. It's about you. So anybody that's discouraged and they're like, how do I remain encouraged through that? Because listen, I didn't have the answers either. And I remember even calling people. I had called my sister one day and I was like, you know, it's good. We good people. We just gonna move on and everything will be fine. And, you know, it's okay. You know how you say when y'all break up, you're like, you know, God's will. Hashtag the plan of God. And it was like, Corey, you just really don't care. But it was me just being like, it's all good. You know, everything is going to be fine. Just be real. If you get discouraged, it's okay to be honest about how you feel. It's okay to be like, y'all, this sucks. Like, I don't want to date anymore. I was comfortable. I don't want to find anybody else. I'm tired, y'all. You can say that. It's okay. Don't stay there, though. I will say that. Do not stay there. But it is okay to be honest with yourself, with God, with those around you to say, hey, like, I'm not feeling it. This kind of hurts because I was used to this for this long and this is not it. This doesn't feel good. This hurts. This is stretching me. This is, you know, how do you readjust your, you know, life to fit something that you had planned? But God was like, sis, I ain't had that plan. Like, did you even come over here to me and talk to me? So that's what I want to encourage you about, because when you see the picture, y'all have no idea the day that I had to get there. But it was amazing, and I cried like a baby because it literally was the prophetic charge that's about to be over my life this year. Is I don't have a clue of what God's about to do. Listen, Kat, the readjustments are so real in 2019. I mean, God just be throwing in plot twists like, "Boop, sis, turn around." And I'm just like, okay, Lord. And I like that. It's not a punishment. It's positioning. Remember that. And it is, readjustments are real. And it is okay. You're going to bounce back. Exactly. So I wanted to just come on before Evan came, because like I said, we're doing 25 minutes, folks. And I wanted to encourage you guys through my story because, you know, and I think God is funny like that, because I really didn't know what we were going to talk about tonight. I just wanted to celebrate my birthday. But God really just is so good like that because, you know, yeah, it's the year of the turnaround. And it's a year of just getting positioned. And it's okay. Because listen, anybody that asked Jarrell, like, how could you survive without Corey? I don't know. Because I'm a great person. Same with him. But we're surviving and we're happy. None of you knew. Like, none of you could tell, oh, they're beefing. We are amicable. That is one of my great friends. I'm his great friend. And just stay encouraged knowing, like Kat said when we were in our other Stay Encouraged, when you go to heal, you think you're going to lose out. You gain. When you are really in the will of God, you gain things. If you feel like it's a loss, readjust your perspective. You have not lost anything. I feel that so strongly. Whoever, I'm gonna take that to myself too. We have not lost a thing, okay? Because when you're in the will of God, there is no lack. There is no loss. He multiplies. He multiplies what he gives us. So don't look at it like it's not the timing. Things are not like they want. They, you know, I'm not going to be pregnant next. Well, I'm not going to say I'm not going to be pregnant next year because I don't know the plans of God. I'm going to be married. If I'm pregnant, I'm going to be married. But what I'm saying is you have not lost anything. So anybody that came on here discouraged and they're like, Lord, you have done some plot twists. You have done some turnarounds. Like, Cassie, you have done some readjustments in my life that I do not like. I am not happy about it. I am not comfortable because I'm in a season right now. I am uncomfortable. It's like when you walk to the edge and you don't know if you're about to fall off the building or if there's going to be another thing there. Anybody feel me on that? And I'm just at the point like, Lord, I'm going to step out. And if I fall, you won't be there to catch me. And if I walk over, you're going to be the land that I walk on. And that is okay. Because my trust and my faith is in you. I have a gift of faith, and I thank God people saw it because I didn't really think, I just thought it was normal. Apparently, it's a gift of faith. And so I'm having faith for whoever is discouraged tonight. Exactly, Daisha, you are my midwife. Birth it out. So I have faith for whoever is on here. Hey, Pastor Evan, I had to come on early because I know I'd be talking, and I wanted to give you your time. So I want to get all this, you know, out of the way. And I wanted you guys to say, I don't want to get emotional. I wanted to just say that I'm honored to be an encouragement to you guys, because there have been days, and this is why I was talking to people and I was releasing words, what is your who? And I know my who, but I want to share with you my why of why I'm encouraged. There was a time in my life where I could not pick myself off the floor, literally physically on the floor, just wrecked. I didn't have anybody to pick me up. One, because I didn't tell them I was going through stuff, but it wasn't there. And I promised God that I will never let anybody sit on the floor. I will never let y'all stay discouraged. And that's why it's called stay encouraged. It's not be encouraged. It's not get encouraged. We are staying encouraged. We are winners. We are staying encouraged. And I know that whatever God is doing in me, I'm pouring it right back out to you. This year of my 29th year, I did not, like I said, I was coming in married. I was supposed to get engaged today, y'all. I was coming in like, woo. I came in single. I came in with some lip gloss on and some sunglasses. And y'all cannot tell in that picture. Thank God, Michael Lawrence brand. Y'all better go to Chicago and get him. But I came in free and I came in whole and I came in the will of God. And I came in ready to bust hell wide open for y'all. Because I'm telling y'all, I feel this so strongly just in life. I keep releasing this verse to everybody connected to me. God is perfecting all things. God is perfecting every single thing concerning you. Things that you forgot about. Things that you don't even think about anymore. I was sitting at a table yesterday and I didn't realize it was a prophetic word spoken over me 2 years ago. I was crying. And so, exactly. It does not make us, it only enhances us. So it's just like, stay encouraged, y'all. So we are going to bring Evan on. Yes. Listen, and I decree and declare that over y'all, that all things, every single thing. And I want you guys to stay encouraged while he does it and remain encouraged. Because listen, hang around me a while and you will be encouraged. So without further ado, because I'm done and I'm going to just release encouragement. I want you guys to all stay encouraged. And I love you all. I really do. I thank God that I can be honest with you guys. I don't, you know, this is just me and I love it. And I love that you guys are here for it. Well, I know some of y'all are here for Pastor Evan, so we're going to let him come out of his throne room, and I'm going to welcome him on. I just want to say in advance, thank you to Pastor Evan. He was on the exchange at the well and wrecked our whole, he shifted my mindset, and this man is good ground. Let me tell you something. I'm going to just, yes, good ground, and he's just a good person, and he's not fake. Like, you know how you meet these people, and you're like, oh, he is not like that in person. He is like the most humble person I've ever met in my life. And I'm looking at him like, there's no way. Like, maybe he has a security guard beside him. I walk right up to him. He hugged me like we was best friends for 15 years. So I absolutely love this man. He is like one of the people that I listen to. And y'all know that's saying a lot. But he's one of those people that I really pull encouragement from. Yes, Evan. So we're going to let you out the throne room. And Kaz, before we move on, I just want to tell you to stay encouraged. I thank you for who you are, what you represent in the body of Christ. And I know that you've had some plot twists, recalibrations, and I cannot wait to just run with you for whatever is about to come out of that. So don't even stay encouraged. You are encouraged. Remain encouraged, Kaz. Like you, I just love you. I just love everything about you. So when I come to Atlanta, we're going to praise the Lord for whatever is coming for you for next. I am excited. So we are going. I'm adding him now. I hope we don't have, yeah. He said, prophesy. I'm just trying to encourage you.
I didn't interrupt the prophecy. I was enjoying it.
No. Hey, so I got feedback. And I was going to text you that earlier. If you have headphones.
Put my headphones in. 1 second.
Okay, I can't hear you. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hey, well,
can you hear me?
I can hear you. Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. Can y'all hear us? Is it good? Hey, sis. Can y'all hear? Is it feedback? Is it good? Tell us so we can jump into this. Cass said, won't the Saints interrupt your word? I know. I'm going to just give you a personal word. I will just reach out to you. But yes, Kat, I'm going to come to Atlanta. Okay, we're good. You said prophesy. I know. I was about to text you, like, I want a real word prophecy on my birthday, Pastor. My hands is lifted up so high. All right, so welcome. You have the floor. I'm done talking. I was smart. I got on before you, so you did not rebuke me later. So go ahead.
I say thank you, first and foremost, for giving me the opportunity to be a part of Stay Encouraged. You were flowing earlier, and I was just kind of listening. I was on for a second, and you were just kind of really hitting some of the things that you asked me to talk about. So I'm kind of figuring, like, am I really supposed to be here now? Because she's covered everything. But thank you again for the opportunity. And I think what you're doing with this platform, just to really, as you mentioned just now, just to encourage people most. You said you made a declaration and a decision when you were on the floor and you could not get up, that you would never let anybody else end up in this particular situation. And so for that reason alone, I just say thank you. I'm excited to be on to share my story and my little tidbit on how to stay encouraged. I have my Instagram live going on over here as well. So just in case I look away, like, it is something, it's for a reason, not just because I'm cross-eyed or something. But so we're gonna jump right into it. So if you're watching on Instagram, if you get disconnected, go to Facebook Live and check it out. Go to my Facebook page. You can join us in the broadcast there. But most importantly, we're talking tonight about how to stay encouraged. You have had some amazing people on this platform with this, one of them being my brother Kaz, and he really he's not just a phenomenal speaker, he's actually a phenomenal person. And so we really kind of built a bond over the last year. So just kudos to everybody who's been a part. Thank you for trusting me to be a part of this. But I'm going to jump on into how to stay encouraged. So I have this thing where I can honestly say I have a really realistic view when it comes to life. I'm a very practical person. I'm one of those people that honestly believe in the power of willpower. There are a lot of things you can do on this earth, but I do know for a fact that once our minds are made up on a lot of different things, there is absolutely no stopping us. So there are a lot of things that sometimes naturally challenge my viewpoint and my perspective, because it's kind of like, how did you get there? How did you allow yourself to get there? Because the average person would be like, oh my God, how did I get here?
Yeah.
But my first thought is always, what did I do to allow myself to be in this situation? At some point, I said yes to something. At some point, I chose not to say, I didn't say no to something. At some point, I had a hand in me getting to this current state or to this current space that I may be in, whether it's a headspace, whether it's a financial space, a destiny space, wherever you are. Like, at some point, we have to be honest and say, you know, I played a major part in me, in my current situation, whether your current situation is absolutely amazing or your current situation is absolutely the pits. At some point in time, we have to just be honest and say, I played a part in where I am right now. So I'm gonna jump on into that. As I mentioned, I'm very real. I'm a very realist. So this may not be as encouraging, but it's going to be extremely challenging. So one of the ways to stay encouraged, and we're talking about encouragement for you guys that are on here. Encouragement is a very powerful tool. Encouragement is one of those things that you can do for yourself. You can find it anywhere you need to, whether it's a song, whether it's a dance. It can be spiritual. It could be faith-based. It could not be faith-based. Encouragement is actually all around us and extremely active. So one of the things I wanted to break at from the beginning was that if you're having a hard time finding encouragement, I want to ask you to ask yourself, why is it so hard for you to find a way to be encouraged? Because encouragement doesn't always have to come in the same form, but it has the same result. Like, it's one of the very few things that can come in so many different ways and from so many different avenues, but it has the same result. That result is always a turnaround. When you're encouraged, everything about that moment, everything about that situation, everything about your perspective always does this thing called a shift. So if you're having if you're having issues trying to encourage yourself or trying to find encouragement in your life, I want you to ask yourself, how is this happening? Am I not listening to the radio? Am I not listening to friends? Am I not even scrolling Instagram or Facebook before 12 noon? Because if you're very honest, everybody's motivational and everybody's encouraging from 7 a.m. to about 10:30. Now, around 11, the good ratchets are back out. And, you know, we're done because we've made it through that first part of the day. And we bless God for that. But seriously, if you're having a hard time finding encouragement of any kind, I want you to challenge yourself in your own perspective as to why you're not. Because I know for a fact it's always happening around you. Jump slide on into this. If you're having an issue trying to be encouraged, I want us all to do this. I want you guys to remember this. I want you, when moments like that, when discouragement is active in your life, when discouragement is active in your situation, I really want you to challenge your own logic and your own thinking and say, what is actually under attack right now? Many of us, we find ourselves in a space where we feel as though we're not encouraged or we're extremely discouraged, and we don't know what exactly is under attack. It's really hard to diagnose. It's really hard to kind of fix something that you first won't diagnose. And for many of us, we misdiagnose it. One of the beautiful things I have written in my notes here, I said that most of us diagnose a branch, but we never diagnose the problem because the problem is root level. We are dealing extensions of the problem, but we never deal with what is the actual problem. So if you're having a hard time finding some encouragement, encouraging yourself in the Lord, whatever it may be, the first thing I want you to really ask yourself is why or what is under attack.